And we are starting now. I could give you a free copy of ZBrush if I want. If I only could do that, I would be doing exactly that. Okay, hey, welcome everybody. Glad to have people here in the chat with me. Let's get going with this. As always, going to be starting with a sphere, just a random old sphere. Okay. I'm just going to start in sculpting on this. So yeah, like I said, in case anybody hasn't noticed in the chat, I'm going to sculpt a caricature of somebody famous. And if you can guess who it is, you win a free copy of Ryan's Tools. So this is somebody famous. I mean, it's most people should know who this is, what they look like, so it shouldn't be too hard. Nothing really obscure. Was gonna do like a character from a TV show, but I was thinking, you know what? I really want to do something that's kind of more my own design today. So get ready, here it comes. So to give away a free copy of Ryan's Tools, basically what I'm gonna have to do is whoever guesses first, you can just go ahead and email me to claim that. And it'll be honor system. Like if I get like five emails from different people saying that they're the one who won it, I'm gonna be very disappointed in everybody. So no trickery. Only the person who actually won it. So how's everybody doing today? In the United States, we had Labor Day yesterday. It's a really nice little holiday. Got the day off. Went to the park. Went to an art fair. Anybody else do anything good yesterday? Any United States people have a good day off? It's been a while since I've done caricatures. It's going to take me a little bit of time here to get my head back in caricature zone. Can you guys hear me now? Cool. Yeah, I just turned my mic off for a second. Had to tell my roommate to be quiet. He was making noise. He didn't know I was on a live stream. So I'm not given any hints, actually. Not given any hints because once this gets underway, and really starts going, it shouldn't be too hard to guess. So no hints. Hey there, Spatula de Futur. I don't know, is that French? Did I say that right? Spatula of the future, is that what that is? So I've got pretty excited today. I'm working in a new office. Previously, my office was temporarily in my bedroom, so now you don't have to see my bed in the background. I'm sure everybody's happy about that. Yeah, it's not really clicking with me either. With caricatures, it's like sometimes it takes a little while for me to kind of find the likeness. It's always frustrating to sculpt caricatures because it's like 30 minutes in and I'm still like, oh, it's just not even looking close. But then, stuff starts to click into place, so. So no worries if you don't get it, because I don't get it either. Don't even know who PR Rogue is, so it's nope, definitely not that. So as a caricature, I'm trying to play with the proportions, see what works. See if I can find that likeness. Hey Naveen, thanks a lot. Any tips for beginners? Keep practicing. And that's the tip for intermediates and experts as well. Keep practicing. Hi Rita, Artie. Naveen, I think you're asking how many years I've been doing characters for. Been doing characters for 15 years. Last several years I've been doing characters, but also been doing a lot of stuff that's more like abstract fine art for as my freelance work. But yeah, I've done all kinds of stuff from working with product design to animation to jewelry. Basically, if it involves a three-dimensional shape, I've been working on it. Tips for keeping motivated during work. Don't know, sometimes I'll put on music, get me through it. I used to say, like, drink some coffee, but I don't know. I like coffee, I just get the jitters from it. It makes it hard to sleep. I don't like relying on it. I just started getting into this stuff. Called raw cacao. It's like chocolate, but unprocessed. So it keeps a lot of the like superfood properties. There's a lot of antioxidants. There's chemicals that are actually related to caffeine, but not the same as caffeine. One called theobromine, and it's actually really, really nice coffee alternative. It kind of gives you some awakeness like coffee, but without the jitters, without anxiety, without crashing later. It lasts longer, comes with a mood boost. I just think this stuff is great. Hi, Cockabobble. Couch otter. Hey, I'm not telling you what you should drink. You do whatever you want. You do you. Who needs sleep? Hey, I love sleep. That's where I get my best ideas. So, in case anybody's just joining us and doesn't know what the deal is today, first person to guess who this is a caricature of wins a free copy of my plugin, Ryan's Tools, which I talk about all the time on here because it's such a good plugin. Hey, I would say that even if I wasn't the one who wrote it, you know what I mean? It's really good stuff. So, if you can guess who I'm sculpting, you're the first one to guess. You win a free copy. It's $20 value, so definitely see if you can tell who it is. Probably not gonna be able to tell just by the ear alone, but once I swing around to the face again, you probably won't be able to tell yet because it's the character, the likeness just isn't quite coming out the way I'd hoped yet, but we're getting there. Say the volume is too low. Well, maybe I can turn that up a little bit. Anybody else have a problem with the volume? So I just cranked up my volume over here a little bit. It's, you win the prizes, definitely not Shakira. Yeah, somebody can tell from the ear alone you get two downloads. That's a good call. He does kind of have a distinctive ear. It's actually one of the more distinctive features on him. So, it is not Sir Patrick Stewart. He would be a good one to sculpt, though. So I just used one of the features in Ryan's tools. It's this thing that grows the mask, shrinks the mask, like in an automated way, make it really easy to do that. So all kinds of cool features, definitely worth checking out, even if you don't win the prize. Ryan's tools is an excellent purchase. Saves me a lot of time. Telly Savalas, good guess. I definitely see what you're seeing there, that, but it is not Telly Savalas. Nope, it is not. Your middle school teacher. Ben Kingsley, also a good guess. No. Leonard Nimoy, no. No hint. If we get to the 2 hour mark and nobody's guessed it, the hair might help. The hair, when I get to the hair, that might help a lot. But yeah, if we get to the 2 hour mark and nobody's guessed it, I might start giving some hints. Or sorry, the 1 hour mark at 2 p.m. my time. Not Joaquin Phoenix. Steve Van Zander, nope. Or Van Zandt, nope. It is a real person. It is a famous person. Jeff Bezos. That's a good guess too. No, it's not Jeff Bezos. Luis Toledano, mucho gusto conocerte. ¿Cómo está México? ¿De qué parte de México eres? Danny DeVito. Now you're just throwing out random guesses. Thanks, Diego. I did lived in Latin America for about 2.5 years of my life. Not a whole lot, but enough to pick it up pretty well. Lived in Chile for about 1.5 years. I lived in Mexico for 4 months, Ecuador for about 4 months. Princess Vespa from Spaceballs before the nose surgery. That's great. Nope, not the Green Goblin. Nope, not Woody Harrelson. All right, I'm gonna get into the hair. Maybe the hair will start to give it away. I'm not gonna give out any hints of like what this person does or what they're famous for until we hit about the 1 hour mark in about 30 minutes if nobody's guessed it before then. Nope. Joe Biden would be a good caricature to do, for sure. It's not me. You guys are hilarious. Not JFK, although I could see how the hair might make you think that. No, it's not the Count from Sesame Street. Steve Carell, no. So that hairbrush, that's one of my custom hairbrushes. It's part of the Ryan's Tools pro extras package. So I mean, it's a gorgeous, gorgeous hairbrush. You know, just if you're doing sculpted hair, I mean, there's just no other way to do it nicely without this brush. It's my own custom creation. Worth the $20 alone. Channing Tatum, Leonard Nimoy, nope. My art station's not updated because I am lazy and I would rather be sculpting than updating my portfolio. I do have an art station. It's just my name, I think. I can't even remember anymore. If you search my name on ArtStation, you'll find it. I only have like two things on it, so I need to update it. Another hairbrush for doing short, stubbly hair. So, Edgar Russ, yeah, you're asking if it's like a good idea to upload to ArtStation at the beginning. I mean, it can't hurt. I would just say as you get better, just remove the work that's less good. So even if you have just three pieces, just put three pieces up, you know? It can't hurt. But as you do, once you do 10 pieces, probably those first three pieces are going to be your least good pieces. So just remove pieces. Keep only like three pieces on your art station until you actually, you know, have put a couple years into it and you actually have a lot of really good work to show. And then you can start showing more than three pieces. Because it's actually kind of a drawback if you know, if somebody's pretty good and they've done, you know, 20 sculpts and most of them are pretty good, but one is really crappy, they just never took the crappy one down, it actually looks bad. You know, it's actually decreases your chance of getting work and stuff like that. So yeah, definitely be curating and editing your portfolio as you go. Now I'm just so lazy and I get regular freelance work, so I just haven't had any need to update my portfolio in years. So it's just not something I think about regularly, which is what happens, you know, when you get to be professional and you get regular work. A lot of people just stop updating their portfolios because it just takes effort when you could be doing other things. It is not Robert Mueller. I already did a caricature of him. If you see my art station, it's like the only thing I have on there. It is not John Hamm or Jeff Goldblum. Or no, I don't think anybody's guessed it yet. So I'm doing this character just because I wanted to do it, just for fun. It's not for work or anything. Thanks, Emperor of Cheese. So if you're the Emperor, have you conquered any cheeses lately? It is not Adrian Brody. It is not Vince McMahon. I'm gonna do some facial hair, some beard. That might help bring it into focus. Seeing some changes I wanna make to this facial anatomy first, however, should help the likeness. I'm not going to give any hints just yet. I'll start giving hints in about 10 minutes if nobody's got it. So the question from Naveen, how can you learn realism in character? Practice. That's my answer for everything. Just practice. All right, let's start putting some stubble on this guy. I'm gonna mask out the parts of the face that should get stubble. You might even be able to get it just from the masking alone. Nope, it's neither Kanye nor Hans Gruber. Good guesses on both. So if you think you know who it is, but you don't know the name, don't give guesses like, oh, are they known for this, that, or the other? Because you might give away the hint to somebody else. So just try to see if you can come up with that name. Edgar, I see you already got Ryan's tools. Nice. Well, if you guess, I'll award you something else somehow. Okay, Edgar S., you got it. It is Volodymyr Zelensky, the president of Ukraine. Good guess. So, for your prize, if you would like it, I will give you a beta version of Ryan's tools, including some new stuff that is probably not going to be released for a few months, and I need to... It's not enough for a full release, but it's got some cool stuff in there. I'll take that. I'll take the criticism, comics legend. This caricature is not going my best so far. What gave it away? At what point did you realize who it was? Huh, something weird happened with the symmetry on that. It didn't follow that line of that lip on the other side. That's weird. Yeah, the beard shape. He's got a very distinctive beard shape. Yeah, I made him a little chubby. Hey, Brian Art. Glad to have you on my broadcast, podcast, whatever this is. Yeah, ZBrush is a very common way to make character art. And for Edgarus, yeah, go ahead and email me. Let me know who you are, that you won the challenge today, and I'll send you a copy of Ryan's Tools version. What is the new version? Two, I think it's 2. Three or two, anyway, whatever the new version is, you'll get it in advance of a public release. I'll throw in some extras as well. I've been working on some new brushes, some new fancy things. I'll throw that in too. So my Gmail is, I'll just type it in right here. Tomb Raid for ZBrush? I'm not sure what that is. Weird. Something got off with my symmetry. I don't understand. It's not doing. It's not playing nice. Cool, Edgar. Looking forward to that. When you woke up this morning, were you expecting to win something? All right, I'm going to save this really quick because you never know when ZBrush is going to crash. Build out his shoulders because he's got pretty prominent shoulders. He's got a pretty decent physique, so his I think his body is a nice part of his likeness. Like total crap. Actually, you know what? I'm going to make a separate object and then dynamesh it together. So Diego asks why my interface looks like this. So I have my interface across three monitors. And so I put all my buttons on my other monitor so I can see just the work I'm working on, just the canvas in my main monitor. So that's why my interface looks like this. And also the background, I've got this grid. It's part of Ryan's Tools. Let me put a link in the chat here to Ryan's Tools in case anybody's interested in purchasing it. There's a free version, which is an older version. And then it's kind of like a try before you buy. And then there's a $5 version for hobbyists and students. And then there's a $20 version for professionals. And it also comes with some extras like brushes, alphas, materials, some other cool fun stuff. And that is $20. Yeah, I'm making his shoulders extra wide for the caricature of it. The hardest body part to learn how to sculpt might be different for everybody. Hands are hard. Eyes are hard for a lot of people. Mouths are really hard. But I don't know. I don't like to think of anatomical parts as being harder or easier. I feel like that's like not the best frame of mind to put it into when you're learning. It's like, because if you think that some part is easy, like there's no part of the body that's easy to sculpt. If you think some part is easy, you might sort of like just kind of not realize you have to give it a lot of attention as well. So every part of the body needs attention. And if you always think of one part as being like really hard, it might mess with your confidence of actually being able to sculpt it well after lots of practice. I don't know, everybody's different. I am not the founder of Vertex School. Right, I'm going to put a shirt on this guy. The hardest one is the one you're trying to learn currently. Yep, pretty much. Is weird. I don't know why my symmetry is all off today. Yeah, I do often have that problem of like asymmetry creeping into models, even though I've kept symmetry on the whole time. But usually it doesn't happen so quickly for me. It is Zelensky. Too bad you weren't here 40 minutes ago when I was giving away a prize to the first person to guess it. But yeah, I'm making him look extra badass, heroic body type and extra badass face. Does anybody watch the other streamers, the ZBrush streamers? What kind of interesting things have they been doing? I usually don't check in what other people are doing, so curious. Anybody else giving away prizes or having people guess what they're working on? Nice Pickle Rick, classic. Oh, that helped a lot. Why didn't I do that earlier? Nice things about caricatures is that if some modification looks good, you can just push it beyond realism and make it even better. Hey, LSDZ29. Thanks for stopping in. I'm going to save it again real quick. Day's going pretty good. Thanks, Mr. Chakeri. I'm not sculpting him as a goblin. I'm just trying to like accentuate some of his features because he has like weird goblin ears like in real life. He's got ears like this. I am exaggerating somewhat, but Zelensky from GTA. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely stylized as a caricature. You know, I'm definitely taking some creative liberties with his likeness. But yeah, glad you noticed. Glad you approve as a Ukrainian. It's nice being in a country where I can do this and not get thrown out of a hospital window. It's always a positive. So, is the student version of ZBrush different from the standard version? Well, there are different versions. I don't know if there's not specifically a student version of ZBrush, but there's like ZBrush Core, ZBrush Mini, versions of ZBrush that are a little stripped down in their feature set, which can be good to learn on so you're not overwhelmed with just too many options. But I'm using the full version of ZBrush. Hey Naveen, there's definitely people making money in the 3D industry. I have been fortunate enough to have made a career off of it for the past 15 years or so. But it's always, a question what the future holds. I don't know. It might become more difficult with AI getting better and better at making 2D and 3D. Then somebody's got to sit around typing prompts into the AI computer, right? Yeah, ZBrush is nice because it really focuses on the 3D modeling and sculpting. Whereas Blender is cool too, but it's so spread out over all the other things it does too. Character artist, how much can they earn? Depends on a lot of factors. In the US, probably gonna earn depends, if it's like full-time freelance, what the situation is, but I mean, absolute bare minimum beginner rate of $20 an hour, but that's like pretty bare bones. If you're decent at all, at least probably $30 or $40 an hour, but then it just goes up and up from there. If you're really good, really established, you've proven yourself, and people want to hire you, you can be making $200, $300 an hour. That's top tier. There's even some real hot shots, some real stars that are making even more than that. Multi kills asks, is this live? No. No, it is definitely not live. That's exactly it, Edgarus. Ryan bought AI. I cloned my brain into the computer, and it's just predicting who's going to show up in the chat and what they're going to say. This is just all pre-recorded. Oh, cool. Somebody who knows me in real life. Yeah, you're welcome. I do remember quite a few of my former students. So if you want to connect or something outside of the live stream, yeah, feel free to send me an email or connect on Facebook or something. Actually, I rarely go on Facebook anymore. Find me on Instagram because I never go on Instagram either. I don't know why I'm saying that. Yeah, Naveen, you're welcome. Glad I could help out. Nice. Thanks for that message there. Multi kills. Were you one of the character modeling students, or were you doing something else? And how has it gone since then? Have you got a career? Have you got work in the industry? Cool, animator at Epic. Hey, glad to hear it worked out for you. It's always sad to hear sometimes some former students end up not being able to make a career out of what they went to school for. I mean, sometimes they're fine. They find that they're happier doing something else. But yeah, some people put a lot of effort into it and weren't able to make a career out of it, which is unfortunate. Especially doing something as that they're passionate about. Yeah, you definitely got to stick with it sometimes. Clients aren't necessarily going to just show up and hand you money. Although sometimes that happens too. Not very often, though. Oh, crap. I put a bunch of detail on the ear on one side and forgot to have symmetry on. I hate it when I do that. He'll just have to have asymmetrical ears, and that's all there is to it. All right, looks like we're getting pretty close to the end of this live stream. So, yeah, that's it for today. Thanks everybody for joining in. Next week, I'm going on Thursday, not Tuesday. So please make sure you tune in for that. I'll have a new character ready to go. Yeah, I enjoyed this one a lot. So yeah, hope to see everybody next time. Have a great one. Bye.